Early assumptions about the impact of the disaster have been refined over time, with research focusing on the nuanced and often subtle ways radiation affects the human body. New diagnostic techniques and long-term observation have refined earlier projections. Recent advantages in genetics have also contributed to a better understanding of the long-term effects of radiation exposure. But Chernobyl's legacy is far from over. The disaster's effects on human health, especially for liquidators and those exposed as children, are still unfolding. Hello guys! Today we continue the series introduced to you in the last few weeks. But first, let me remind you that a new trailer for Chernobylite 2 was published on Tuesday. More gameplay and less cinematic, so judging by your reception, it's really good. Don't forget to wishlist our game on Steam, the link is in the description. But for today, let's focus on the legacy that Chernobyl has left behind. Chernobyl Disaster Impact, Part 4. Chernobyl Disaster Effects 40 Years Later. Nearly 4 decades after the Chernobyl disaster, precisely speaking 38, almost 39, its effects are still being felt by populations in Ukraine, Belarus, Russia, and often other countries as well. In particular cases, the Chernobyl accident continues to shape public health discourse while new studies regularly emerge. They expand our understanding of the long-term consequences of radiation exposure, and Chernobyl is a grim example of these effects. For you to better understand the issues, ionizing radiation has enough energy to affect the atoms in living cells, and thus damage their genetic material, DNA. The variables are important also when speaking about the long-term effects of radiation exposure. Internal variables, let's call it personal, are for example age, gender, individual health risks and genetics. So basically we could say that it's all about the state of your body when you encounter the radiation source. External variables are for example how long the exposure takes place, how strong the source is, how equipped you are, and if you have any protection. That's why the Chernobyl effects are so troublesome to evaluate. Most of the liquidators were not even equipped with dosimeters, at least in the first days and weeks. They were also not warned against the radiation exposure they may have, and cancer prophylactics were almost non-existent in the Soviet Union among regular citizens. So early assumptions about the impact of the disaster have been refined over time, with research focusing on the nuanced and often subtle ways radiation affects the human body. Initially, concerns centered around acute health problems, like cancer. Still, as more time has passed, the focus has broadened to include cardiovascular diseases, mental health, and the broader impact on ecosystems. Recent studies have provided further insight into the relationship between radiation exposure and cancer. For instance, the cases of thyroid cancer in those who were children at the time of the disaster continue to be closely monitored, particularly in regions like Gomel, Belarus, where radiation levels were highest. New diagnostic techniques and long-term observation have refined earlier projections, showing that while the initial spike in thyroid cancer was severe, there is also an ongoing risk for other cancers as the exposed population ages. The focus on thyroid cancer has now expanded to include other radiation-induced conditions, including leukemia and solid tumors, which may not manifest until decades after the initial exposure. Countries most affected by the disaster, particularly Ukraine, Belarus and Russia, have taken varied approach to managing Chernobyl-related health issues. Ukraine, in particular, has faced challenges due to political instability and economic difficulties, which have strained its healthcare system. Despite this, Ukraine has continued to invest in monitoring and treating those affected, with specific programs dedicated to liquidators and evacuees. Belarus has similarly focused on public health surveillance, particularly in the Gomel region. In recent years, international organizations including the World Health Organization, WHO, and the International Atomic Energy Agency have worked with these countries to improve healthcare access and conduct research on the long-term effects of the disaster. One of the most significant ongoing concerns is the psychological impact of Chernobyl, which is often overshadowed by the focus on physical health. Studies have shown that many individuals exposed to the disaster, particularly liquidators and evacuees, suffer from chronic anxiety, depression, and post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. The psychological burden is compounded by the social and economic instability in the affected regions, leading to a vicious cycle where poor mental health exacerbates other health problems. Addressing this aspect of the disaster has been a challenge, as mental health care infrastructure in Ukraine, Belarus and Russia remains underdeveloped. Recent advances in genetics have also contributed to a better understanding of the long-term effects of radiation exposure. While initial studies on the children of liquidators produced mixed results, more recent research has provided clearer insights into how radiation affects DNA. It is now understood that while there is an increase in DNA mutations in some cases, the transmission of these mutations to future generations is less common than initially feared. This has somewhat alleviated concerns about widespread genetic damage in the descendants of those exposed, but the risk of other long-term health consequences remains significant. Internationally, there has been a renewed focus on Chernobyl-related research, particularly in light of more recent nuclear incidents, such as the Fukushima disaster in 2011. The lessons learned from Chernobyl have informed nuclear safety protocols worldwide, and the data collected from survivors of the disaster continue to provide invaluable information for understanding the risks of radiation. For example, studies of Chernobyl's impact on wildlife and ecosystems have shed light on how radiation affects different species, which has important implications for environmental protection in regions affected by nuclear fallout. Despite the vast body of research conducted since 1996, many questions remain about the full extent of Chernobyl's long-term health impacts. Some studies suggest that radiation may be contributing to a broader range of health problems, such as increased rates of cardiovascular disease and immune disorders. Recent research has explored the potential for radiation to affect the nervous system, leading to cognitive impairments and other neurological issues. However, these findings are still preliminary, and more research is needed to establish definitive links between radiation exposure and these conditions. Looking ahead, the health impact of Chernobyl over the next 40 years is likely to be shaped by both the aging of the affected population and the development of new medical technologies. As the liquidators and evacuees grow older, their risk for radiation-related diseases like cancer will likely increase. However, advances in cancer treatment and early detection could mitigate some of these risks. The growing field of personalized medicine may offer new ways to treat individuals based on their specific genetic makeup, which could be particularly beneficial for those exposed to radiation. One of the key challenges in the coming decades will be ensuring that the healthcare systems in the affected countries are equipped to handle the ongoing health needs of Chernobyl survivors. As political and economic instability continues to plague the region, particularly in Ukraine, access to healthcare may be limited for many of those who need it most. International aid will likely continue to play a critical role in supporting these countries, particularly in funding research and providing medical care for Chernobyl survivors. Finally, there is the question of whether some of the common health issues seen in the former Soviet Union could be linked to the Chernobyl disaster. While radiation is certainly a factor in the increased rates of cancer and other diseases, other factors, such as poverty, poor nutrition, and lack of access to healthcare, also play a significant role. Separating the impact of Chernobyl from these broader issues is difficult, but ongoing research into the health effects of radiation will continue to provide valuable insights.
An official announcement from the Council of Ministers. There has been an accident at the Chernobyl atomic power station. One of the atomic reactors was damaged. The consequences of the accident are being taken care of. Help is being given to the victims of the accident. A government commission has been set up.
Chernobyl's legacy is far from over. The disaster's effects on human health, especially for liquidators and those exposed as children, are still unfolding, and new health issues will likely continue to emerge in the coming decades. While much progress has been made in understanding the disaster's impact, there is still much to learn. And the international community must remain committed to supporting the affected populations as they continue to grapple with the long-term consequences of Chernobyl. As always, I hope you have learned something new or interesting thanks to our video. Share your thoughts, and if you want to add something, or you would like us to add any information, please write us in the comment section. Same if you want to ask anything, feel free to comment. remember to watch the new Chernobylite 2 gameplay trailer released earlier this week, and to wishlist our new game on Steam. You can find the link in the description of the trailer and this video too. That's it for today, guys. Take care, stay safe, and see you next week.